We're going to track down. We're going to do some running down. God told me to do this. I remember teaching this. Let's go back to Second Corinthians, excuse me. 2 Corinthians 12, and this is where we're gonna camp out here because we got to get this. 12:9, 8, 9, and 10. This is, we talked about Paul being caught up. We talked about Paul, God, how God told him he was going to suffer. To suffer means after we suffer, we are able to reign. Christ learned obedience through the things that he suffered. He learned obedience through the things that he suffered. Now, the Bible tells us to pick up the cross. When Christ got off the cross and finished the work that he did, he was raised to glory. As I was studying, the Holy Spirit said, we want to bypass the cross, we want the glory, but we don't want the cross. The only way to get the cross, you got to bear it every day. Pick up your cross daily. It's got to be a daily chore. God ain't changed his mind about this stuff. But so many believers want his glory. Christ was raised and established back in the glory, but the cross is there before the glory. Christ had to learn suffering is not a bad thing. But in that sense, Christ had to learn obedience. He was 100% God and 100% man. Can I say this? You're 100% God and 100% human. I'm telling you, we can't change that. God ain't changing what he said. This is why he had me to pull them two verses. He ain't changing it, but the church has been, and it's our fault. I'm not excluding me from this. It's our fault right here. But I'm a troublemaker because I didn't follow them. Do you know Jesus got in trouble because he said he was anointed? He was the Messiah, and he was only speaking that which he was. And the religious leaders of that day hated him for it. I found out when I speak with authority, without what I know and whom I've been called to speak with, I get the same thing. You're going to get the same thing. People don't want to hear that. They want you to stay in the boat with everybody else. But we're going to go back and check this out. I guarantee you, if you hear me, you're going to be blessed tonight. You're already blessed. But we don't realize how blessed we are. God ain't playing with this stuff. And I'm so glad Mom Abram said something. And he said, now, you go back and pull this out. You done taught it. It wasn't a big study. Because all I had to do was sit down and let the Holy Spirit line it out the way he wanted it. I have taught this. But the other churches that hear this stuff, say, this Negro, I'm going to say it just like he crazy. See, he unlearned. He ain't been to the seminary. Yes, I have. I just don't want to teach all that. Yeah, that PhD in biblical studies, I got it. Where is it? That thing broke. The frame broke, and it's stuck back somewhere in my dining room. I might put it up. Anyway. Here we go. Three times I called upon the Lord and besought him about this. Anybody ever besought the Lord about something? I'm not saying this because Paul said it. I was a young Christian, and I was struggling in some areas. I was struggling in this particular area. And I was upset because I wanted to please God. I know this thing wasn't pleasing God, and it was eating me up. I'm like, I can't sleep because I really wanted to be a good welder. I learned how to weld. I learned how to paint. I learned how to lay bricks. And I was pretty good in all. Anything I put my hands to, I want to exceed average in it. Some people go, well, that ought to be good enough. That will track. You've been pretty people that do that stuff, they pretty much been like that their whole life. sweep the trash in the corner and leave it there. My daddy used to do that. He'll sweep. He used to clean up and put it right in the corner. Get that trash up. It'll sit there. I'm like. But people that have do things, that ain't by happenstance. You done worked yourself up in a way of have doing things. Uh-huh. But that night, I was crying. I got on my knees. I said, Lord. And before I got the request out, just like Paul here, he said, go to bed. My grace is sufficient. My power, my ability. I knew he wasn't talking about just him dying on the cross. Him dying on the cross provided something. Y'all better hear me. Write that down. Him dying on the cross provided something. You already know that, but it provided me to overcome. He did not move it. And when he told me that, I rested in the word that the Holy Spirit gave me. In order to hear the word of God, you're going to have to hear it in the spirit for it to move you. If you hear it with physical ears, it's not going to do anything. It's going to be just like me talking. If we was in a 900 square foot building and I didn't have a microphone on, it'll be just like that. But with a mic, it'll be expounded. When I hear the Spirit, when I hear certain scriptures given through the children, through somebody up here reviewing a Sunday school lesson, pow, it hits me just like that. It's like a drum or something. Pow, it hit me. Uh-huh. And I know that's what I need to meditate on right there. Why did the Spirit illuminate that verse? I know I need to hear it. So I'm trying to help you. So if you're struggling, we ain't struggling no more this year. I don't care what's going on in this earth today. God ain't changing. He's the same now. Three times I called upon the Lord and besought him about this and begged that he might depart from me, that it might depart from me. But he said to me, my grace, my favor, my loving kindness, and mercy is enough for you, sufficient against any danger. Now, let's talk about any danger. Let's talk about any danger because I'm setting the lesson up. And I'm going to have to run for time. Set against any danger. What is he talking about here? His listen now. He said, my grace, my favor. This is in the Greek. My favor. My loving kindness. And mercy is enough for you. I receive that into my spirit. Sufficient. Sufficient. How many lessons did we have on sufficient? See, if you ain't got that in your arsenal, then you ain't through studying. If that should be in you, that is a staple to your foundation. See, saints, if you're not going to staple, get these scriptures and what we're doing, then you're not going to be on a building block. You know, the foundation, it's going to take time. But these are building blocks in your arsenal, in your walk with God. I'm sufficient in his sufficiency. I'm depending on the finished work of Jesus. I'm depending on the blood. I'm depending on his stripes. All of it was significance. All of it is. And I lean toward that. Anything of mine, I ain't leaning toward none of me. Because I know I'm insufficient. I'm incomplete. I'm inadequate. But some of us, and I are too smart for God. I just got to go there because you won't trust what he's doing. I'm telling you, I messed up at 17 and God just let me run wild. And he said, now, you need me. Where else did I have to go? People hadn't run out yet. Don't think God is the answer. This is why you're going to keep trying. You're going to keep doodling on your little chalkboard trying to figure things out, and you hadn't figured out God is the answer. I'm glad God let me bump my head because I know the world system ain't it. Y'all better hear me tonight. Hear me. Listen to me. I'm coming with passion and love and respect for God's people tonight. Hear me? Hear me? Now, get this in your spirit. Sufficient against any danger. Enables you to bear trouble manfully. You can bear this, what he's saying. My favor, my grace, my strength, my loving kindness is enough to help you bear any trouble, bear any danger manfully. That's even in your flesh. It's going to help you. What's in you going to help you bear what you're dealing with? is his ability. Do you hear what I'm saying? All right, let's get on so we can get to this. So he said, my strength and power are made perfect, mature, complete, fulfilled, and completed. Listen, and show themselves most effective in your weakness. I went to God and told him I was weak here. How many people gonna lock away with God and tell God you weak here? Here you would never get. You would never get it. You would never get his strength in that area if you don't open up and say, I'm struggling in my faith. But don't nobody want to do that because you too strong in God. I'll let you struggle with this for 30 years if you want to. He ain't gonna do nothing. When you say to him openly and humbly that you can't, he said, good. Man, I can't preach. See, this is what the parishioners want somebody. They want somebody that an orator. They don't want a preacher. They want an orator, somebody that dot the I's and cross the T's. There's nothing wrong with speaking good English. I was a student in English. I don't use good English. I just gave the teacher back what she wanted. I loved English, but I don't talk good English, but I talk good enough for God. But see, to the educated, I don't make sense. Preachers have laughed at me because I pronounce words a certain way. But there was an anointing on my life. They recognized, so they had to point something out that could make them feel good about themselves, knowing they were lacking what God had put on me. See, the church can't be like that. We cannot be like that. Will you admit that you're struggling here, wherever it at? I guarantee you the struggle is over. It's over. I can rejoice. See, I'm excited about that because I've experienced that. But some of us don't. We ain't tired yet. Well, that's your little red wagon. Well, Apostle don't say that, but it's true. That's your little red wagon. You got to say it. I said it for me years ago. This was in the 90s. I never will forget it. And all of a sudden, I could feel the power of God come up on me. And even though the thing was present, it didn't faze me because I knew now God had gave me a word. See, I had to trust God to preach because he called me and I ran for 3 years because I didn't think I was equipped. What am I doing now? Oh, yeah. This is how God wants all of us. What's in here? Empty. This is how he wants you. You can't come to God already filled. You can't. You can't. God got a plan for your life. And he's gonna put in your life what he desired for you to carry out what he put you on this earth for. I'm telling you. I'm telling you now. Let's finish reading this verse here. I'm reading from the Amplified. This is the Amplified. So it says, my strength and power are made perfect, fulfilled, complete, and show themselves most effective in your weakness. The only time you are going to display his power is when you're weak. Not at your strongest. Because if you're at your strongest, oh, see, them super saints ain't going to want to admit that they weak. Them super saints ain't going to. What did Christ have? What did Christ have? The anointing. Christo. That wasn't his last name. So how was he able to overcome the anointing? What he had? He said, I can do nothing of myself. Look at Jesus. See, when we read those verses, we don't get it. You got to hear it in the spirit. I can do nothing of myself. I can do nothing of myself. I can't be a good husband by myself. You won't be a good wife. You won't be a good daughter or a son. You won't be a good worker. You won't be anything without him. Jesus knew it. I say nothing of myself. I only say what I hear the Father say. Why? Because the anointing was in what the Father told him to say. If I teach what God tells me to teach, it's going to be most effective and powerful. Now, everybody might not get it, but for those who receive it, it's going to do the work. I got to follow the prescribed order that God has given kingdom faith. This is why it's called kingdom faith. It came. Your faith came out of the kingdom. Therefore, listen, here we go, saints. Therefore, I will all the more gladly glory in my weaknesses. I'm so glad. Who going to do that? Who going to get their praise off? Because they're weak right here. Hallelujah. I had to go back there. I'm going back now to show you what's available. Will you glorify God because you're weak right here and you know now his strength is available for you to overcome in those areas so God can get the glory out of your life? Did I say anything wrong? No, God loves you, but God don't want you to think it's all about you. That's why he said, not many noble, not many mighty, not many wise men did I call, but I chose the fools. Here you go. Look in the dictionary. Look in that 79, 80, 81, 82. I was coming out of my ignorance, but I was still there. You'll see my picture in that dictionary. Fool. That was me, court jester. I'm being honest. But God knows how to confound the wise. He takes the foolish thing. God loves you, and he want to get the glory out of your life. He want to get the glory out of you, your family. He want to get the glory out of the gifts. Receive my worship. I want him to receive it. He'll give you the spirit. He gave us everything to do, everything he's asking us to do. Now, it says, therefore, I will all the more gladly glory in my weakness and infirmities. That's weakness and infirmities. That the strength, underline, and power of Christ the Messiah may rest, yes, may pitch a tent over me and dwell upon me. Now, wait a minute. It's in you now. It's in you. I said, that's a good verse to set up where I'm going here. Can we go to 2 Corinthians now? Reggie, I want this from the King James. 2 Corinthians 4 and verse 7. I want you to get this. I want you to get it. You may be down, but you ain't out. I'll tell anybody, get up. Get up. Get up. I'm so glad that God had his hand on my life when I got away from all them people that were doing the things that he pulled me away from. And he put me under something. He trained me through playing baseball. And every time when I started pastoring, and I was going through a lot of people because the people didn't want to change it. What I was teaching was tugging at them because they saw all I was doing was teaching on love when I first came. I was advised to teach on sin. And God said, teach on what I told you, teach love. Who don't know how to sin? Raise your hand. Born in sin, shaped in iniquity. We already knew about that. So when I went to teaching on love, it started bothering them. Love. Rev. Daniel, can you teach anything else? I said, when you start doing it, I will, because I'm going to teach what God said to do. I was going to a series, I don't know how long I taught on love, but they got tired of it, because I was teaching on love. And it was going to work in me, too, because that was the area I needed work on as well. Well, God knew what he was doing. 2 Corinthians 4, 7, but we have this treasure. Oh, glory to God. I'm finna track down some stuff. This is the way God wants. We have this treasure in earthen vessel. Now, this was in the earth. Glass, God put this stuff here in the earth to make glass out of. All right? Man is taken from humus. They got humus at lawn and gardens. Dirt. You look up the word, God formed man out of the dust of the ground. Humus, we're made. The container. The container ain't the blessing. I don't care how pretty you are and how everybody doing all these exercises. You got women and men wanting to get the six pack, wanting to get all this. They doing butt exercise to get their butt big. That ain't the treasure. That ain't the treasure. You can do all them butt exercise, go get butt implants. And bodybuilders can't develop muscle. They go get chest implant, calf. Arnold Schwarzenegger had calf implants. He couldn't develop them. You can't develop every muscle part. They go get implants. They have surgical done just like women do. That ain't the treasure. That ain't the treasure. So if you're looking at a wife or a potential wife or husband, you better look deeper. You better know if the treasure, get that back up there. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. The treasure, baby, what is the treasure? I'm telling you. Huh? Big arms ain't gonna get it. I got big feet and a big mouth to go with all that. But the treasure in me is God. In you, God. Not your hair, and you can spend a lot of time on that and not work on the other part, and you're going to miss out. I ain't saying nothing wrong. Because a spiritual person going to look at, they're going to look deeper, they're going to look past that earthly experience. Wait a minute. There's some danger there. Did I say anything wrong? I ain't said nothing wrong yet. We have this treasure. Give me 13, Reggie. Can you go to 13? Well, give me the next verse, because I'm not over there. Let me turn over here real quick. 2 Corinthians. We're going to run down some stuff. 2 Corinthians 4. Let me see where we are. Here we go. Here we go. Give me 8. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. Wait a minute. Paul is letting you know. We just got through reading what Paul said. My excellency, that the power may be of God, right? And everything that Paul went through on his missionary journey, did he go through a lot? This is Paul talking from experience. We are troubled on every side. Wait, how many sides? Front, back, top. We troubled every way you can look, but not yet, not distressed. Look at Paul. Perplexed, but not in despair. Look at Paul now. Come on. What did he call? God told him, my grace is sufficient. My power, when you're weak, persecuted but not forsaken, cast down but not destroyed. You better get in this. What caused it? The excellency. Verse 7 is what caused everybody, Paul and everybody, them apostles, to go through. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus. Y'all better get this. That the life of Jesus. That, so if you won't die, if you won't pick up your cross, wait a minute. The life also of Jesus might be manifested in your body. How can it be manifest when you on the throne? Can't do it, y'all. This is why Paul wasn't perplexed. This is why Peter said, hang me upside down. This is why Stephen was stoned to death. And he said, Lord, lay not to this charge. He didn't say, sick him, Jesus. You got to say, God going to get you. And I told one tried to tell me that. I said, why he ain't got you yet, then? Don't come in with that psychology on me. You can't pronounce a curse on me. What did they tell that you can't curse what's blessed? That prophet tried to curse God's people. He said, I can't curse them because they're blessed. But the church think they're blessed. I mean, cursed. They think they're cursed. Come on, we'll get to that later. For we which live are already delivered unto death. You're already dead. You're a brand new creature. You're born again. You better know that. You're 100% God and you're 100% human. Which one you going to cater to the most? I'm telling you, I live toward my spirit. I got to. That's where my strength is. That's where my life is. Okay? If you want to bear about Jesus Christ and make him manifested in your life, then you're going to have to get off the throne. It can't be about you and what you want to do and how you want to do it. Might be made manifested in our mortal flesh. That the life also of Jesus. Wait a minute, the life of Jesus, wasn't it obedient life? Wasn't it an obedient life? Wasn't it a godly life? Come on now, that life going to appear through you, not you. Not you. God is trying to get something done here because he made a promise so many years ago. We going back. Come on. We got time. Come on. So then, death worketh in us. It do. But life in you. Paul is letting the people know. Because they life is in danger of him preaching this stuff. But they say it's death in us, but it's life in you. Come on. We having the same spirit. This is where I want to get to. We having the same spirit. All of us in. If you're born again, we got the same spirit. Listen, of faith, according to as it is written. God ain't changing. I believe. And as I believe, y'all hear y'all apostle. And therefore I've spoken. What I believe, you hear me speak it. I'm going to release it in the atmosphere. We also believe, and therefore, when a person don't believe, listen to them long enough and you'll hear what they believe. Apostle don't listen. He won't get nobody. Yeah, I hear. I hear well. I hear what you're saying. But now I don't put it in the category of unbelief or belief. We got to always talk faith. We got to always release it in the atmosphere. We got to release it. Come on. It says, knowing that he which raised up the Lord Jesus shall raise up us also by Jesus and shall present us with you. All right, now, let's go here. I'm going to get into the lesson tonight. I'm going to write this down. This is our topic for tonight. I did all that to set up the lesson for tonight. Tracking, and I hope you get the legits of what I'm saying. Tracking the bloodline of the blessing. Tracking the bloodline of the blessing. Tracking the bloodline. Obedience and blessing. Ain't we been going? I set before you. See, I want you to understand what a blessing is. God said, I set before you blessings, cursing, life or death. And we're going to get an understanding of what the blessing is. And it's all through the Old Testament and it's all through the New Testament. It's written all through, but what is a blessing? You go in one church, you will hear that God wants you blessed, prosperous, healthy, wealthy, and all this. You go in another church, God wants you sick. God wants you poor. The church is confused. They're confused. God don't want you prosper. God wants you broke. It's a blessing to get sick. I've heard people say, if it wasn't for me losing my job and getting kicked out of my house, now God, the Holy Ghost can teach me. You think God wants you? Wait a minute now. Wait. You see how crazy? Oh, that's a blessing in the sky. What? That ain't no. Let me. See, that's not a blessing. And God didn't disguise this. It's hidden from those who are not his. Okay? We're going to do something. All right? The word blessing has been stripped of his meaning. It's been stripped. Being broke is never a blessing. Being broken can be a blessing. Broken, blessed are the poor in spirit. Well, God said he wants you of a contrite heart. What is that prayer? Over in David prayed that prayer of consecration and rededication. David rededicated when the prophet came to him, told him about himself. And that Psalm 50, number one. People pray that not for a rededication, but to try to get God to move in their life. Do they not know that's a prayer of rededication? David was rededicating himself. David was once faithful, and he fell away. So he went back and rededicated himself. And I've heard people pray that, and I told his pastor, I said, you can't pray that. They got mad with me. I said, that's not to get a blessing. That's David's prayer. What's your prayer? All right, let's go to Genesis, please, 1:22. We're going to go back to the beginning and track this thing. We're going to go all the way back. Genesis 1:22, Reggie. We do it all is from the King James. I ain't gonna try to get into Genesis 1:22. And God blessed them. Wait a minute. You see that word blessed? What is that? That's the blessing. Right off the bat, what did he do? He blessed them, saying, be fruitful. That God blessed them and giving them a mandate. God is giving them the blessing and giving them an assignment. He put the anointing on their life to carry out the be fruitful, multiply, fill the and fill the waters in the sea. Wait a minute. Wait. Do y'all see this? God wasn't going to do this. Adam and Eve were going to get this done. And he's giving them the authority and the blessing to get it done. God will never ask you to do anything and not equip you to get it done. I'm graced, the pastor. I'm anointed to do it. It's on me. It's on the office. The power is there if I obey. Blessings if you obey. Cursing if you don't. We're going to get to this part. We're going to see why it ended up like that. Come on. And the evening and the morning were the fifth day. All right, let's go to, let's read, come on. I want 27 and 28. But we're, let me get over here. We're going to track it down. Okay, let's see. We can get 24. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures, cattle and creeping things. Earth of his kind, it was so. Come on, next verse. And God made the beast after their kind. Look, wait. Bag it up, Rich. Bag it up. And God said, let the earth bring forth every living creature, underline, after his kind. I'm telling you, God ain't changing. God didn't change his MO. Everything produced after his own kind. Get where God is going with this now. I can go back to 22 and show you. All right, but right here, come on. Forth the living creature after his kind, cattle. Look how many different breeds of cattle. Now, man got in there and started cloning and started breeding and crossbreeding, creeping things, and beast of the earth after what? His kind. And it was so. Next verse, come on. And God made the beast of the earth after his kind, cattle after their kind, and everything that creepeth upon the earth after his kind. You better underline kind. And God saw that it was good. Come on. Watch this. Now he's getting the man. Let us make man in our image after our kind, after our likeness, and let them have, I'm giving you what I got. We don't want it. We don't want that responsibility. We don't want it. Adam had it. He lost it. This is the blessing. We're tracking it down, y'all. God wants you to have dominion. This is the blessing. This is the mandate. And the church don't want the responsibility. But I got to walk in it. God was saying, you stay bold. You got to walk in authority. You're going to get gunned down by a lot of people, but you know who you are. And I'm trying to tell y'all who you are. Not in the Thompson family, but in the royal priesthood. See, I'm royalty. I'm royalty. So my mindset changing. I'm royalty. I go in the store thinking royalty. God got favor on me. Come on, y'all. We got to get this. I'm so glad God said that through my baby and it struck me. So I listen.
Hey, y'all listen.
I listen to what I need to listen to, put it that way. Amen. All right, let's get this. Come on, watch this. And God said, let us make mankind. You weren't just talking about man. God is not a chauvinist in our image. Uh-oh, after our likeness. We look just like God. Now, that ain't what we're talking about. And let them have dominion, mandate over the fish, over the fowls of the air, over the sea, over the fowls of the air, over the cattle, over the earth, over every creeping thing that creepeth upon earth. And when I ride by the road and see all that trash people throw out, don't you know God go judge us how we messing this earth up? Man going to have to bear. Come on. The image of God wouldn't do all that. What happened? So God created man in his own image. In the image of God. He after their kind. He ain't changed. We ain't using the word. We got image now. Galatians 5:22 is the image. Love will show forth. I don't care how much you know. You better have some love there. If you can love and forgive, you show forth the image of God. That love, without love, there'll be no joy there. There'll be no peace there. Come on now. Come on. So God created man in his own image, and the image of God created he, him, male, and what? Female created he there. Man, woman was in. Now, this is the struggle, and this is what hurts me. This hurts me. That they were together, and God, when he pulled her out to fight, and Satan knows this, is to keep them separated. Why is it they could flow when he was in Adam, when she was in Adam, and now he got her out to walk beside, it can't. That's, God ain't God, it won't oneness. It ain't what you think. What did the word say? That's what should be said. Well, who got the better idea? The word ain't no idea. It's an authority, and the word got a blessing on it if we do it. I'm trying to get you back under what God, under the mandate where the blessing is. This ain't about no feelings. This ain't about nothing but being obedient. Ain't that what started all this? Come on. I'm telling you, this is blessing me because it's a refresher call. I don't remember everything, but that Holy Ghost of show will bring it back up. Come on, watch this. Here we go. And God blessed them. Wait, what did he do right off the bat? God gave Adam, the garden was over in Iraq, modern day Iraq. Go get a calendar and you'll look at Iraq and you can see how big the garden was. It wasn't that big. Adam ain't never done this before. He was like God. He could look in the face of God. Adam and Eve could. He could do. He named the animals, and he didn't get not one of them wrong. But yet, put that back up there. Put that. God blessed him. And God said unto them, be fruitful. The garden was a little old spot. As anointed, and the blessing was on Adam, he didn't give him more than he could handle. So what you're dealing with right now, God won't put more on you than you can bear, but it ain't God putting that on you. You putting it on yourself. Adam could handle this, and he worked a long time before Eve came on the blade. But, all right, watch this. Come on. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of the earth, and every tree in the midst which is the fruit of trees yielding seed. Wait a minute. They were full-grown trees yielding. Notice he didn't start off Adam with a baby. Made a baby in the dirt. He made a man, full-grown man. But this time, since he gave man dominion, he had to start with a baby. He couldn't go against the order he set up. God ain't changing. After our image. After our likeness. This is where the church is struggling at. This is where the church and anybody teaching this stuff, it's erroneous teaching. They teaching all this. Oh, they call this, what do they call this? Word of faith. This ain't no word of faith. God, this come out of the Holy Bible. Come on. In the which is the fruit of a tree yielding seed, to you, and it shall be meat for you. God want us eating fruit. More so, man, we ain't eating meat yet. He wasn't a meat eater yet. Okay. All right, let's move along. Let me find my place. All right. Give me two. Genesis 2 and 8. I'm going to skip through this. I'm going to pick back up on this Sunday. Going back, I ain't no hurry. We're going to get it. 2:8-17, but I need to get, 1. I'll go back and get that. And the Lord God planted a garden. God spoke all that, now he's finna recreate, now he's finna create. God speak and then he come back and do. And in that Bible, Mama, even you'll be able to see that chronological. The Bible is not in no chronological order. That wasn't what God was trying to do. He was trying to get his word to you, but if the order of it is not in order. This is why you need the Holy Ghost to do this. And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, God's present. Eden, Eden, our home should be Eden, God's present. And there he put the man whom he had formed. Go, all right, come on. And out of the ground made the Lord God to grow every tree. See, here it is, it's going now. These trees grew up, that it was pleasant to the sight, good for food. That pleasant to the sight is what got the woman. That's what Satan, that what Satan used through the serpent to get the woman. Anything look good, gonna catch somebody's eye. And good for food, the trees of life, also in the midst of the garden. And the tree of knowledge of good and evil. There it is, there go that tree. There go that tree. That was God's tree. The tithe is God's tree. Now let me go right here. That's why God told everything God made, and he made Adam and Eve in his image and likeness. God had to put something in place to separate man and them. You don't touch this. This is mine. This put differential, Adam, between me and you. This is mine. This is off limit. God didn't tell him why. And see, yeah, we're God and we're made in his image, but this is off. You can't touch this. This is God. Tithing is not a cure-all. I can live any kind of way I want, and I just tithe, and it's going to be all right. How many times have you heard this in church, just tithe? But with no obedience, what is it going to do? Not one thing. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Come on. And a river, listen, a river went out of Eden. This is Adam's home. This is what God gave it. Do it sound like a ghetto? Now, outside of this was nothing created. Nothing. Inside of, now, you ought to be getting this. Outside of him, you're going to struggle. Adam toiled outside of this, didn't he? But he had a blessing on him. To water the garden. It didn't rain back then. God had a water system, a sprinkler system under the earth at that time, where it watered the plants from the roots. And from this, it was parted and became into four heads. Come on. It was the river. The name of the first one is Phison. This is which compasses the whole land of Havilah, where there is gold. Adam had everything he knew to carry out the mandate. God, the boy wasn't in no ghetto. This is God's son. Now, what's wrong with us being God's son? The blessing is on him. And God is showing him everything that he got at his disposal. Come on. And the gold of that land is good. There's Beledum and the onyx stone. Come on. And the name of the second river is Gihon or Gishon, Gihon. The same is that compasses the whole land of Ethiopia. God knows what he's doing. Come on. God had a water system to water the garden for the boy. The name of the third river is Helical, that it is which goeth toward the east. It went to, look at that, of a Caesarea. They became the enemy of children of Israel. And the fourth river, Euphrates, is Euphrates. Come on. Come on. And the Lord God took the man. Now, I want you to get this. This is the garden. I'm going to move up here where God is outside of Eden. Everything is waiting on. Now, he spoke him. Took him. Man became a living soul. God put his life inside of him. All right? Come on, son. Let me usher you into. Now, he was created in nothing and ushered into abundance. Nothing abundance. He should have said, hold up, God. Hold up, Father. Nothing abundance. And he got kicked out into what? Man been hanging out here for how long? How long, man? How? And we struggling. But why? Why? Because the blessing is back in circulation, but we still living in the fall. I ain't struggling. I know who I am, but I'm trying to get my wife and my kids in the church to understand. Quit limiting yourself to the fall. I ain't fell. I done got up. The anointing, the blessing got me up. In that commercial where that old lady and them comedians used to laugh and make, I fall and I can't get up. I would turn the channel. Why would you laugh at an elderly person fall? See, that's just my pet peeve. That ain't funny to me. That's not funny. But to some people, that's humorous. That, and I believe those same people laugh at that in the fall themselves. I got up, baby. I got up. You hear what I'm saying? Come on. Look at it. And the Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden. To do what? To dress. Adam just wasn't a weed puller. He going to give him all that power just to pull weeds? Come on now. You much more than what you want to be and what you are and what you're afraid to probably step up into. You have a royal priesthood. You better know that. Took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. Come on. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat. Giving him the very thing he needs to keep the blessing intact. Obedience. Adam was godly, but he still had to obey God. This is where we struggle at, with obedience. Oh, I'm saved by grace. I can live any kind of way. This is what the pastors are preaching. The grace message. The grace message. You got these preachers on TV preaching Joseph Prince and all these people talking about grace, and you can live any kind of way and still have God's favor on your life. Well, I'm a little old country preacher here in Mississippi telling you strictly what the written book says. If Adam was made in the image and likeness of God, and he was sinless, and he's telling him he need to obey, what is that telling us? Come on. But the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat. Remember, there's two trees in there. Everybody, they don't talk about the tree of life that much. You don't hear people talking about the tree of life that much. We talk about this one, because this is the one that caused the trouble that we now have. Thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt. What do surely mean? Who got a phone? I want you to look up surely. So we won't miss that. Because no, I don't believe God to do that. Well, was he talking about taking a dirt nap? No, he was talking about being cut off. This would disconnect the blessing right here. There it is. What was it? Obedience? Obedience did or disobedience? Now, you need to make up your mind. Do you really want to be blessed? Then you're going to have to obey. Now, if you make up your mind to obey, there's an anointing for you to obey. Y'all didn't hear me. If you make up your mind to obey God, there's an anointing you can walk into to walk upright and tight all day long. But the enemy, now here go the deal. You need to clean yourself up, because if you don't, the enemy going to constantly pull you. Hey, you must forgot about this over here. I see you're walking right with God, but you still got some stuff right here that you need to get rid of. Since you ain't got rid of, I'm going to tempt you. Come on, come on. Don't you want this? Hey. So you get this stuff out where Satan won't have a reason to try to tempt you and pull you out of the blessing. That's what he did with them. It's the same M.O. It's the same M.O. Come on. And the Lord God said, it is not, there we go right here. This is what started, all right? Let's move along. We see here come woman now. Amen? So, give me Genesis 12. Make a long story short, we already know what happened, though. Cain, after the fall, Cain killed Abel. See what, they weren't blessed anymore. They lost it. Now hold on. God had to figure out a way. You need to read in between the third chapter and the fourth and the fifth and the sixth to get the whole gist of that. Now God said, I got to get the blessing back. Genesis 12 and 3. Here we go right here. Give me one. We'll read it through 3. And I will, come on. Go on, bag up the one. Now the Lord has said unto Abram, get thee. This is the second time he called Abraham. Abram, he wasn't Abraham. Yeah, this is the second call. The first time he called him, he took his daddy. God didn't tell him to take his daddy. He said, get your family. Leave your daddy's house. Leave the country. Get thee out of thy country from your kinfolk and from thy father's house. Now, kindred is one thing. Father's house. What did you learn in your parents' house? See, you need to understand, you got some teaching that's probably causing your marriage to be messed up, causing you to be messed up. Get rid of that junk. Abraham's daddy was a moon worshiper. They believed in many false gods, and we're holding on to stuff that we learned. I'm just telling you. He said, get rid of all of it from thy father's house unto a land that I will show you. He got a little move before I show you. Abram had to leave. This is the second time. And guess what he did? Lot went with him. Come on. Listen to what he said. Third verse. Watch this. If you go, not knowing where you're going. See, we want to know everything. You ain't going to know everything with God. The man that wear the hat, he said, you got to have faith. That song, you got to have faith. He said, would you believe it if you couldn't see it anyway? Would you believe it? You can't see it and then believe. You got to take God's word. I will bless them that go. What is God doing? What is he doing? Reestablishing. God is putting this thing. Now, it's through obedience. I will bless them that bless thee. Curse him that curse thee. You ain't got to fight. You ain't got to get back. Let people do what they do and get out the way. God said this. And in thee shall all the family. Look at God speaking way, Jeremy, like I said last night. God is speaking way down up and past us and to your children, boo, to your children, to your children. God know what he's doing. But it's predicated on obedience. Wow. All the families of the earth shall be blessed. Where did he put the blessing on? Adam and Eve, in the beginning. Where were they at? In the earth. Why is all this going on? Anybody want to answer that? Please answer. Why is all this stuff going on in the earth today? Where is the blessing? It's still around. But you're not going to get God's best living any kind of way. If you want God's best, you're going to have to give your best. I never seen nobody win a trophy half playing. Or win the greatest prize of all, have doing what you was going after to do. Come on. And so Abram departed as the Lord had spoken. He got away from my family. I don't want to leave my family. I know you love your family. I love my family too, but I love God more. Your family can't bless you. Now, don't miss the mistake of what I said. I ain't telling you not to visit your family. But I remember when I first got saved, the devil got in my family. And God ain't seen my mama in a while. Because I was busy working. I was working overtime. I was doing everything, but I was going to church. My boss let me go to church. He said, Daniel, I said, look, I'm supposed to be to work at 10 o'clock on Sundays. Sunday school started at 9:45. I said, can I go to church, Sunday school, and then come to work? You know how many hours I left? I missed. I missed a lot of hours. I didn't care. I wanted to be at church. I worked at night. I didn't get off till 4:30 in the morning. I went to work at 10 and didn't get off till 4 the next morning on Sundays. But he let me go. So, put that back up there. He let me go. So, I departed. I did. Had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him. And Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. Now, wait a minute. 25 years passed before the child came, before the seed of the promise came. What hindered it? What hindered it? What's hindering your blessing? You're going to be talked about living right with God. You're going to be ridiculed. I don't care. But listen, I'm going back to what my mom, I went to see my mom. I was working hard. I went over there. I went fishing. Some of them went out here about Petrified Forest. I went down to this place. I used to go fishing there, and I went over there, pulled up. God told me on the way there, don't go. I said, Lord, I'm here rationalizing with God. But Lord, I ain't seen my mama. He said, don't go. I said, Lord. He said, go on. I went over there. She come out. The man next door come out. And my brother Billy came out. And that demon got in all three of them. And they cussed me for everything that I was worth. And I sat on the edge of that car and just laughed. I said, you told me. I didn't even tell them back. I got in my car and pulled off. I said, see, I had to go through that to know that, learn that God knew what he was talking about. They wasn't ready for me because I had pulled away from them. You see why God told Abraham to get away from around his folk? I had to pull away from them because they said, he's trying to be like this person. I'm trying to be like. I'm only fulfilling the call that God, they didn't understand me. They thought I had lost my mind. But all them drugs that I was doing, my mama never once said I lost my mind. When I picked up the Bible, you done lost your mind. I said, well, ain't it funny when you didn't say when I was doing all this stuff, you never said I had lost my mind. You thought I was in my right mind. Now that I'm saved, I'm crazy. So be it. Listen, come on. Abram took Sarai, his wife, and Lot, his brother's son, and all their substance and all they had gathered, and the souls that they had gotten in Haran. See, he had some stuff that he even shouldn't even have with him. His baggage gone. You don't have to let go every weight and sin if you're going to follow God. They went forth into in the land of Canaan. You know Lot and Abram had a little dispute. They cattle after they got, the story went on, Lot men and Abraham men. Now, the cattle, they had grew so, the blessing in their life had prospered them so that the herdsman, Abraham saw it, and he went to Lot. He said, I pray there be nothing between me and you. It was between their workers. It hadn't reached Abraham and his nephew yet. Abraham, being wise, headed it off and said, you choose. You go away because we can't stay together. Called him problem. Lot should have said, Uncle, I'm only blessed because I'm with you. But Abram, being the wise man, he let him choose. But Lot should have in turn said, you know what, Unc? You have blessed me. What's on you have gotten on me. You too. Abraham never probably would have chosen to go down near Sodom. That boy went down to Sodom. He was outside the gate. One year, next year, he up in the gate. And the Bible says he was vexed. His righteous soul was vexed from the homosexuality that was going on in that town. That's what's wrong with our earth today, is vexed. Do you not know this stuff is trickle over in the animal kingdom? I've seen two lions mating, males. I didn't say lioness. I said two males. The man sin is trickling over in the animal kingdom. I'm not lying. And we're going to have to give an account of this stuff. God is not playing. The blessing will not work where sin is. All right, let's move along. All right, let's go to Deuteronomy 7, 12 through 15. Let's get that. So we see how we say, man, God is blessing me. What happened? I got me a car. I got this. Let me share something with you. The car ain't the blessing. The blessing, we're going to get there when we finna close, is where we was on Sunday. Galatians 3. The blessing is the anointing. The anointing produced the car. Your obedience, the blessing is on you and in you. That ain't the blessing. That's residue of the blessing. And we done missed. Achoo, bless you. Why would you bless somebody because they sneeze? And God blessed them. Didn't you see how true in that verse? Man, I'm the world. It's funny, but I'm trying to show you how we done got caught up in this stuff, and I'm trying to get you out. Come on, Reggie. Watch this. Where? Wherefore, it shall come to pass, if you hearken to these judgments and keep them to do them, that the Lord thy God shall keep unto thee the covenant and the mercy which he swore unto thy fathers. You're going to hear this a lot if you go through all these verses I got. The theme is unto thy father. He's talking about the promised seed coming through Abraham. That's what he's talking about. He's talking about, I promised Abraham something, and I'm going to fulfill it. And Abraham looked at his body and said, he said, man, looking at me and my wife, we done dried up, and when I look at me, ain't no hope. But Abraham kept hoping against his natural hope. See, when you get a word from God, you got supernatural hope. Remember I taught that series? You got supernatural hope. Well, because God made sure he let them get weak and dried out where they couldn't perform. And now, they're good and out my way. And that's what it's going to take for some of y'all. Y'all in God's way. Come on. I will love thee and bless thee. That go take out that word. I told you we tracking down the bloodline of the blessed. It's all predicated on obedience now. Multiply thee. He will also bless the fruit of your womb and the fruit of the land, the corn. God will bless in everything. What producing the corn? What producing the child? What producing the flocks, the sheep, the cows, the horses? That was what they were riding back then, the donkeys. God, the blessing produced all that. But Will said, that's the blessing. Let me help you identify. It's an anointing. Did this happen to anybody? No, the blessing produced it. The blessing put this building up because the people, when the guy said, he said, the total cost of this building is going to be $140,000. And I took it back to the church. $140,000. I'm like, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Because you put a number before black people, it'll scare. So I got a chalkboard. I said, watch this. We're going to break this down by not even put the tithes in there. Just do this and that and timed it out. And the contractor said, this is what y'all can do this. And when I stood up and said, we're going to build a church, an anointing came on me, and the money came from everywhere which away. And it scared me. I'm like, God, golly. When God get ready for us to do something, it'll be done. It's going to be done when he get ready. But I'm building a church right now. I'm trying to bless the church. Point to yourself, temple. If I can't get you built, we're going to have trouble. I don't want a 3,000 seat with all that hell in it. 3,000 seat ministry and everybody in there living jacked up. Calling themselves blessed. No, I don't want that because it ain't real. You obey, you'll see something, you'll see some miraculous things happen. Come on, come on. I'm trying to help you. We got to get out of here. And thy corn and thy wine, thy oil, increase of thy kind, the flocks and the sheep. You see that? Come on, next verse. This is the blessing. This is the blessing. That faithful Abraham come to thou shall be blessed above all people. Do you hear me? God is talking to us. United States shouldn't be going through this stuff that's going through. But we can help turn this thing around. Y'all don't believe this. A little leaven a whole lump. If it can mess a lump up, we can sure doggone blow it up for righteousness. Let's flip the coin over. I believe in flipping the coin. I see the worst side, but I'm looking at the good side. Come on, come on. Thou shalt be blessed above all people. There shall not be male or female barren among you. Among your cattle, everything gonna produce. Now, let me get the verse, and I'm running for time, so we can close out. Let's get the verse that got me here. Galatians. Let's get Galatians 3. Oh, this blessed me tonight. I'm blessed. How about you? The anointing in your life will produce the blessing. Obey God. Obey God, y'all. Obey God. Children, obey God. Obey. This is where I'm at. I'm going to walk in obedience, and I'm going to live right before you. I know what I do is tied to y'all. I'm not finna mess y'all blessing up. Please don't mess mine up. Please. Will you do right? Because God loves you, and if you admit that you weak, then the blessing comes. But you too strong for the blessing. Come on, Reggie. Come on. We just all want one after. Come on. We want to get you out of here so you can go home and relax. Galatians 3:10. That's good, but I'm gonna start at 10. We're gonna go and get you out of here. Yep. You're right. 13 was it, Reggie. I'm sorry. For as many as are the works of the law are under the curse. See, when you think you're strong, you're under a curse. That's where God wanted me to go with that. You cursed. Because you tried to work it out yourself. curses everyone that continueth not in all things which are written. No, if you're going to try to do this, you got to continue in the whole book. Nobody could do the law. Jesus did it for us. See, in him is the blessing. He did it. Come on. But that no man is justified by the law in the sight of God. You ain't going to be justified trying to work it out yourself. It is evident for the just, the righteous, shall live by faith. The justified in God through Christ, we got to live by faith. Come on. And the law is not of faith, but the man that does them shall live in them. You want to live by the law and keep trying to please God, trying to work it out yourself, trying to make two ends meet, you ain't going to never make ends meet. You got to live by faith. Come on. Christ has redeemed us from the curse, the anointing, the blessing, pull you out of that curse of the law, being made a curse. Jesus was cursed. For it is written, cursed is every man that hangeth on a cross. That was a pine tree. That's a pine tree. Somebody brought me up, Pastor, let me give you this little cross. What is it? It made out of willow. The real cross is made out of pine tree. Somebody got some wrong information. That's wrong. It was made out of pine. Because they just wasn't going to hang one tree. Pine got sap in it. Why? It lasts long. How many people got nailed to a certain cross? Them cross didn't just dry up and rot away. Pine don't do that. All right? Curse. All right? That a curse in here. Why? Christ took the curse that the blessing of Abraham may come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ. That's the blessing. That ain't a Cadillac. I ain't read a Cadillac. I ain't read a five-bedroom house with seven bathrooms, a swimming pool on 30 acres. I ain't read that. It said a blessing of Abraham may come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ that we might receive the promise. What is it? The Spirit of God. Through faith, that's the blessing. And that will produce the car. That will produce the house. That will produce the job. So we know what the blessing is. When you get your stuff, they just tell them, nah, baby, that ain't the blessing. That ain't the blessing. I wear the blessing. I got it in me and on me. We got to close. It's five after. This is our lesson for tonight. Hallelujah.